your live Super Doppler 4 HD weather forecast.
And live Super Doppler 4 HD, we've got the sweep in the yellow color, which means we're in the alert mode. Doesn't mean that we have any warnings across our area, but it could, once it becomes red, that means we're under either some type of watch or warning. I doubt if we're going to get under a watch. It'll just be individual thunderstorms that could be severe. And we do have a severe thunderstorm warning that continues for the Charlotte area. And we also have severe thunderstorm warning in parts of northeastern Georgia, but so far not in our viewing area per se. Take a look at live Super Doppler 4 HD. Now, we do have those very heavy and electric thunderstorms moving through northwestern and northern part of Spartanburg County. But in the yellow boxes, that's where we have the warnings. And you can see we had a very heavy thundershower move through downtown Asheville. Now it's actually moving into the western part of Marion County, and it's heading for you folks in Marion and per se in McDowell County and heading for Marion. You can see these heavy thunderstorms, though, moving into the northern part of Spartanburg County. More thunderstorms now, but weakening somewhat just north of you folks in Walhalla up into around Salem with some brief heavy rain. But especially back into northeastern Georgia, these thunderstorms have been quite strong. They actually started all the way back to around Dahlonega, kind of redeveloped farther to the south, moved over the northern part of Lake Lanier in northeastern Georgia. Homeward, get ready for these thunderstorms. If they continue to stay strong, they may eventually make their way over into Franklin County, and that's when we'll put out a warning, so we'll see about that. Now, these thunderstorms have been below severe limits. Remember, a severe thunderstorm criteria is 58-mile-per-hour winds or greater, or 1-inch diameter hail or greater, and we haven't even been close to that. But we've had gusty winds, but very electrical thunderstorms. A lot of lightning. They started out in through eastern part of Henderson County, all of Polk County. You folks in Columbus got hit by these heavy rain thunderstorms, very electrical thunderstorms, almost continuous lightning, strong gusty winds, and maybe even some small hail, but they're not classified as a severe thunderstorm, even though they're very electrical. These thunderstorms are moving through you folks in Boiling Springs. Storm Tracker has them sliding off to the southeast at about 30 to 35 miles per hour. In the next few minutes, they're right over you folks in Boiling Springs and in downtown Spartanburg, possibly at 6:27 of this evening. Live shot looking over Lake Hartwell right now, and some thunderstorms off in the distance. 91 in Abbeville, 91 degrees current temperature in Lawrence, 91 in Greenville. We've cooled the temperatures down a little bit, but humidity levels remaining fairly high. And we had a heat index of 99 earlier. Still, it feels like 98 degrees in Greenville. 98 the heat index in Abbeville and in Elberton, 99 the heat index, almost 100 degrees outside in Lawrence. We have a little bit of a breeze out there out of the south and southwest. It's 97 degrees current temperature in Augusta, 95 right now in Columbia. All right, here's a stationary front to our north, but we have these little pieces of energy coming in from the west in the upper atmosphere, and that's colliding with the heat and humidity across our area. So we'll see thunderstorms continue to fire up again tomorrow afternoon, and a few of them could be quite strong. A marginal risk for severe weather. Tracking the tropics still. Here's the Lesser Antilles. This was an 80% chance of developing. Now it's down to a 60% chance of this low pressure actually becoming a tropical depression or a tropical storm. So it doesn't look very good. It's going into an unfavorable environment over the next several days. It may be around here by Tuesday of next week, just off the southeast of the coastline of the United States, but it may just be a low, so we'll keep you updated. All right, tonight, muggy conditions, a stray evening, strong thunderstorm, low 72, scattered showers, thunderstorms this evening, mainly for the mountains tomorrow, hot, humid, scattered thunderstorms around the area, especially in the mountains. 4-day plus looks like this. Still hot, humid conditions. We may drop the humidity levels a little bit and dry out a little bit Sunday and Monday of next week, and then the heat and humidity returns by the middle of next week. Now back to you, Gabrielle and Michael.